beyond the sacred land. I need... to find Olin and learn everything he knows. Who the killers were, how they saw me through his focus. Who the woman is, one who looks like me. Why they want me dead. Olin's trail leads to Meridian. When I catch him, he will talk. And he will pay for all the lives he's ruined. Thank you. Saving these for the trail. Useful. Watching. I'm picking up another signal. Killers. What are they doing here? Fallen. May the sun light their passing. Here we go again. I've made these Flintoks back. I better speak to whoever's in charge.
Thank you. We're exhausted. It's the third flock we face today.
Hardy little plant. You'll help. Forget about traveling light.
Why did this have to happen?
You just flew in on a rainbow and saved our sorry slags. Where'd you come from?
A man named Hackard outside the village warned me.
Traitor! I ordered him to stay put! I'll throw him in irons!
He's dead.
What? That scorched out, filthy, rotten dirtwad of a brother! Why didn't he listen? Why?
He was worried you and the entire town would be killed. Do you have any idea what could be drawing the Glinthawks? Has anything changed that might have lured the Glinthawks? Have you left machine scrap lying around?
No. Us around use our scrap. Not like the Carja. They only keep the pretty parts.
So the Carja have been leaving scrap around?
Here? Never! If a Carja wasted scrap on my watch, I'd pick it up and make him eat it.
Why do you think the Carja have anything to do with the Glinthawks?
We built this outpost to protect against the Carja. Now they're coming here to trade. Fine. Their shards are as good as anyone's. But everyone knows that they want this place. Come to think of it, they want every place.
But how could the Carja have brought on the Glinthawks?
If I ever get a break from them, I'll see if I can spare a man to follow the trail. Guaranteed, there's a Carja at the other end.
Has anyone come trying to sell lures? They're devices that attract machines.
Is that real? Is that some sort of Nora joke?
I'll take that as a no. What exactly do you do here?
I'm the mayor. Mostly because I was too drunk to say no when my brother asked me. Tell me where he is, and I'll lay him to rest once we get these Glinthawks to flock off.
You'll find him due south of here, along the river.
Damn that fool. That bung. That lunkhead. Thank you for being with him at the end.
Why don't I investigate why the Glinthawks are attacking? You've got your hands full.
Really? No one ever offers to help me. You any good at tracking?
You could say that.
All right, then. Let me know what you find. Hammer to steel. A Carja is behind all this.
What are you doing?
By the sun! It won't turn off!
What is it?
I didn't make it. I scrounged it from a workshop. Whatever it is, ever since it's been on, these Glinthawks have been attacking! I don't know how to make it stop!
Well, that should do it. Now start talking. Why are you scrounging gear you don't even understand?
My customers demand extraordinary pieces best found at the fringes of civilization. My tales of adventure only increase their value. Where others only dare tread, I flourish. No mountain climbs too high that I can't mount it. My trade demands sacrifice.
Including the sacrifice of innocence? Those Glinthawks swooped down and attacked everyone.
I didn't mean for that to happen. I sought only to sate the appetites of rich nobles who never leave their mansions.
Did you know this whole time that that device was luring Glinthawks?
By the sun, no! I stashed it here for a while, but when I came back, I was nearly beheaded by one of those flying terrors.
You mentioned—
Yes.
Enough. Were there any other devices at this workshop?
Abandoned equipment, the likes of which I've never seen. A peculiar silo remained impervious to my attempts to open it. As I searched, I wondered how many secrets lie hidden in this world, as we, in our ignorance, go about our daily—
Your point?
Oh. No, I didn't see another device. But one could still be there, waiting to unleash its horrors.
This device is dangerous. I have to find that workshop and make sure it's the last. Where is it?
On the eastern ridge, just beyond my campsite. But after I descended from the workshop, a cracking above me signaled my doom. I dove into the river mere moments before an avalanche took out the path. You can't reach it now. The climb is too perilous.
I'll take my chances. You just stay away from that workshop and try not to cause another mess. That car just said the workshop was near his campsite on the eastern ridge.
How could we defend ourselves again?
campsite, so the workshop can't be far. If I can find a way around the avalanche. The snow's got a bite out here. Oh boy. More than equipped to take you on. But Allure brought that Stormbird here. If I find any and destroy them, the machine should leave. Whoever this Dervahl is, it sounds like he's made a lot of enemies. For good reason, too. Now to bring word back to Pitchcliff.
It was all I could do to protect my family.
Any one of us could have died.
You'll be happy to know I found another one of those lures and destroyed it. Should be the last you'll hear of it.
By fire and spit, you went above and beyond. How do you know there won't be any more?
The workshop where I found it was long abandoned. You're safe.
Good. My troops want to spit and shake your hand, as my brother would have. On behalf of Pitchcliff and my family, I thank you.
okay. Don't kick. Need them soon enough. That's it. Nothing to see here. Solid ice. I'm not getting through here. This must be the pass O'Tor was talking about. The nuke territory just above. This one's a new predator. I can see the heat coming off it. They know where I am. And one of these. That's a welcome, I guess.
Ha! You sure you'll be warm enough up here, Nora?
I've worked up a sweat from the climb.
You made it to the cut, Outlander.
Not that you'll stay long.
Smoke rising from the mountain. And the village, too. What's it for?
Abandon it. Our chieftain has led our best to the deaths. Where should we find him?
Must be something big going on. Most of the village is moving towards that smoke.
Get ready for a rare sight, Nora. Burgrind, purveyor of necessities. Most of the time, the Banuk burn their dead, but not today.
Because the bodies couldn't be recovered.
Aye, a nasty business. All their best warriors, lost. So they're getting a different kind of send-off.
Grasp your grief, my hunters, and kill it! For our kin sees the fate all Banuk long for. Falling with their spears striking steel. Their struggle is over now. You have witnessed their spirits rise up into the blue sky and beyond to the blue light. But our struggle is only beginning. Soon, we will again take up the hunt against the daemon that frenzies the machines against us. And so I ask you, can you summon the courage of our fallen kin? Will you fight and die as well as they did?
My courage! My spear!
Our blood is in your teeth, Aratak!
We are Banuk. Our enemies are prey.
A daemon that frenzies the machines.
Machines that wiped out their best. And what do they want to do? Go back up there. Fools. A little advice, for free.
Aloy.
Aloy. I've been up here for two long winters, and I still can't make sense of the Banuk. Take this ruckus. It started with one of their shamans, Aurea, spouting on about spirits and daemons up on Thunder's Drum. So they march their Warwick up there, and half of them get slaughtered by machines. When Aurea vanished, I thought the crazy might have gone with her. But no. Here's Big Aratak, gearing them up to do it all over again.
What is it about the Banuk you can't make sense of?
Well, everything's a test to them. A hardship to endure. A challenge to survive.
Seems like they don't have much of a choice in a place like this.
Yeah. A land cold enough to crack teeth. Filled with wild animals. You think they'd accept a little reasonably priced aid. Well, believe me, I've tried to convince them. But a Banuk with nothing left to prove might just lie down and die.
And Aurea is the one who spoke about this daemon?
That's right. Told Aratak and the others that it lives up on Thunder's Drum. And they believed him.
But you don't.
Look, I don't know what Aurea found up there. A shaman's not going to talk to an outlander. The machines in the cut are getting more vicious, that's a fact. It could be because of the daemon. Or it could be because they all got indigestion, for all I know. But Aurea's not around to explain. She took off, and no one knows why.
Is Aratak a renowned warrior around here?
He's a Warwick chieftain. His voice carries a lot of respect. Not that you hear much of it. Man talks about as much as a dead fish. But when he and Aurea came to town with their Warwick, it drew more Banuk to this little burg than I'd ever seen. Know what else I saw, Aloy? My own little trade route, stretching all the way back to the claim. Then, he goes and leads them off to their death at the claws of angry machines. So much for my best customers.
What are these Warwicks about, Burgrund? Some sort of tribe within the tribe?
Yeah, not like our clans back home. You don't get born into these things. They hold tryouts. Prove your best at something and you might get a place. Some Warwicks come and go. Some last as long as metal. The whole Banuk territory, Banur, is just a bunch of the biggest, oldest Warwicks.
I'm not sure if I'm less confused or more confused.
Well, here's the sure thing. Each Warwick has a chieftain and a shaman. They make the decisions. All well and good, except the chieftains are hard-headed, and the shamans have their heads in the clouds.
You said you've lived out here for two winters?
Aye. Back home, some fur traders told me about this steel-forsaken heap of tents. Good location. Ripe for change. We were barely scraping by until this place started filling up for Aurea. A great prophet is coming, they said. I heard prophet. Honest mistake. Not that the Banuk are stingy, they just prefer to keep trade among themselves. We could get through to enough of them. We could really put this place on the map. Or at least on a map.
We?
Me and my daughter. My assistant, Varja. My assistant and my daughter. We seem to get along better as business partners. Her mother wanted me to show her a trade. She started tinkering with weapons. Say, when you need a break from this Banuk carry-on, stop in and see her. You're both, how do I put it?
Women?
No. Independent. Look for her at Long Notch, the easternmost Banuk camp.
I want to know more about this daemon.
Mm-mm. It's crazy talk, Aloy.
Or there's something to it. Something connected to how the machines behave.
Then you need to find Aurea. She was last seen headed for the mountains they call the Ice Rests. I've heard only the shamans know the trail beyond those frozen peaks. But I do know where you could find her apprentice, Naltuk. He went north of the river, chasing rumors.
Rumors?
Not the good kind. Sudden attacks in the snow. Strange new structures. Some say a new machine, like no one seen before.
Well, now I'm definitely interested. Thanks for the talk, Bergrund.
Don't mention it.
I wonder if Aratok can tell me
machines
more about Aurea.
Machines in the south suffer their own sort of corruption.
Might be worth a shot.
I wonder what sort of challenge they present.
I do not want to hear this talk from you again. Doubt is heavier than a week's snow.
Forgive me, my chieftain. We will be ready for the next attempt.
But this will not be an attempt. It must be done. Do you understand?
My chieftain.
Good. Outlander, I suppose you wish to speak?
Did your Warwick come from this place?
No, we rallied most of our hunters from across Banur to face the threat of the daemon. But I was born here and stayed to fight the Karja when others retreated into the mountains. A few of my old warriors remained with me, those who survived.
There are other Warwicks in Song's Edge, too?
Yes. The village has its own life for all Banuk who need trade or shelter. After the war ended, it sprang up from what was once a campsite, quick as the bloom between frosts. Perhaps it will last until the Karja seek war again.
This daemon you talked about.
If you are hardy enough, you can venture out and see the signs yourself. It has changed the machines, made them fiercer, stronger.
But what is it?
A matter for the shamans to debate.
Aurea knows about this daemon. Where would I talk to her?
She does a shaman's work. That is not for the eyes and ears of others. Certainly not an Outlander's.
You're set on going back to the mountain?
I have put my word to it.
Even with the risks being so great?
The risk of what? Death? It would be a worse fate to bow our heads to the challenge and say too much.
Well, I guess that's it then.
Good. I prefer deeds to words.
Right.
May you survive and prevail.
Weariness.
Pleasant days.
Deep din. Silenced by rising waters.
You seem sad, stranger. I heard you mention a flood.
Yes. A sudden deluge, without rain or melt to explain it. I'm Laulai, the drummer of Deep Din. Or at least I was, until it disappeared under the waters.
Deep Din? What's that?
A hollow, carved out by the old ones. A chamber, a basin, and a musical instrument all at once. My life, my calling. I'd explain it by playing for you if I could, but its pipes are deep under the water now.
So Deep Din is a place and a musical instrument?
Yes. Pipes that carry a perfect tone beneath a sonorous basin. A wondrous edifice the old ones used to carry music far and wide. During the war, My father played the pipes to rally the Banuk against the Karja. I'm the drummer now. But our battles are few and far between. Mostly I play for the joy of it. Or to remember my family. Of course, if the waters don't recede, what's the point of joy? Or remembering?
So the waters came fast.
One day it was dry. The next, the nearby river had risen and the entire basin was flooded. I don't understand it. There was no rain, not even any clouds, and yet the river rose higher than I'd ever seen it. And there it remains.
A flood without rain. That is strange. Where is this place? I'll have a look if I'm in the area.
Just northwest of here. Look all you like, but I don't see what good it'll do. The floodwaters aren't going anywhere. How does one ask a river to relent? No more music.
some place.
We should not pile his father's guilt. Water lapping on old stone. That's a sound to sleep to, not live to.
When the old ones were fresh in their graves and our numbers were still
small. He's not a normal bandit.
It was she.
Oh, no, my father's crown. It would torment him to see.
Okay, if I want to learn more about how this daemon affects the machines, I've got to find Araya. And to do that, I need to talk to her apprentice, who followed the river north.
Just looking at them makes my chest feel hot.
Outlander, wait a moment. That weapon of yours, Outlander, that spear, I can see the blue light upon it.
You're not the first to take an interest in it. I've made it myself.
Your own design, and yet you are not a shaman.
No. More of a tinker?
A tinker does not understand the spark in the metal, the song in the metal like this. But it could be improved upon, modified, with the help of the old ones. Far north of here, there is a cave, a shaft in the snow. Within it is a nest of metal birds. Find a bird that hasn't been stripped by shamans past. Look for a rail inside it, the length of your spear. That's all I can tell you.
Get a rail from some metal birds in a cave. Sounds perfectly normal.
Have you ever heard the tones of these big? You Outlanders have.
Any news from the hunt?
The herd isn't roaming far from the camp.
Keep them together this time.
Then we wait. But I bet.
Outlanders. Fresh as it comes.